we're initially building this technology to fix what's broken in the brain. So we've all experienced things either ourselves or with our friends and family, Alzheimer's or Parkinson's, depressions, anxiety, stroke, traumatic brain injury. All these things affect our lives. And we'd like to be able to build a technology that can fix these things that are broken. It's very much our objective to improve our own cognitive abilities. Humans always do the things that improve themselves the best. So for example, we drink coffee to improve our mental state. Right? We wear nice clothes and take care of ourselves to look nice. We read books to become better educated. We go to school to become better trained. We do things to improve ourselves. This technology will simply be a continuation of the things that we already do to try to be our best selves. A lot of people who are new to the idea of thinking of an implant as a way to treat disease or dysfunction or to improve their own cognitive abilities would be surprised to know there are already a few hundred thousand people in the world who have chips implanted for deep brain stimulation for Parkinson's. So we already have a couple hundred thousand people in the world who have these implants. I certainly will. We live in a unique time and place currently where we literally have the ability to increasingly author any kind of world that we can imagine. We can program our genetics. We're now trying to program our brains. We're able to program our biology. For example, taking E. coli and programming that to produce something different. So we have these technologies that allow us to do things we never could before, which literally makes us authors of our existence. With any technology, there's always questions of ethics and morals. This is not a question, however, of if we should develop it or whether it will be developed. It is being developed. Humans have never been able to stop the development of technology. At the same time, I can't imagine anything more beautiful, anything more inspiring than to imagine that unlocking and improving my own brain. I think the question that I am consumed with is what exists beyond what I can taste, touch, feel, experience, imagine, and create. There's a whole world that we don't know exists.